Good afternoon, students. We already started the unit number 5, skills for interviews. From this unit, we are going to discuss today two points. First is the preparatory steps for job interviews, and second point is the interview skills tips. Now, preparatory steps for job interview, we are going to discuss first point now. In this, when you are, that means anybody is getting the call letter, at that time what happens? Sometimes he gets some, that means he behaves like having the fear. Fear in the sense what? Might be he is in his mind, even though he is having the good confidence, having that much knowledge about that particular post and all that thing. Skill, he is having good skill, even though all these things he is having, but in his mind maybe it gets the fear about that, the how the interview will be there, can I get rejected from this process, all these things will come, and again one more question will be, then how my friends and family members will react with me, like that he will get that particular thing. To avoid such a thing, right, you have to again increase your confident level and say yourself that don't worry about that thing, whatever may be happened, let it be. Like that you have to think, and before attending that particular interview, you have to prepare yourself for that particular interview. Then that interview may be any kind, that may be face to face, that may be telephonic, or that may be any video conferencing, whatever may be that interview may be there. You have to prepare yourself so that you can say that you will be ready for any type of that particular interview process, and you can go, that means with good confidence level. That is the, you can say that one important thing you have to consider one. Okay, and for this preparation, what you have to need important thing is that you have to aware about the complete interview process. You have to aware about that particular complete interview process. And by considering these things, you can prepare yourself and you will attend that particular interview process in a proper way. Right? Before attending any interview, right, you have to know about that particular organization, which kind of the organization is there, which kind of the post it is considered by that particular organization. You have to understand that thing. You have to understand the requirement, minimum requirement of that particular organization for that particular post, right? That thing you have to know. Whatever the skills you are having, whether it is matches with that particular post, and it is, you can say that whatever the whether it will complete the need of that organization, that you have to see that thing. Then you have to know about the interview formats, which kind of interview formats may be considered there, what the process may be there, and whatever the interviewer, they are asking that questions, we have to react on that particular question in a positive manner. You have to have the confidence while giving that particular answer. These things you have to adopt, or these things you have to do before attending the interview. And another, some points are there. You know, whenever that interview is considered one, at that time you have to reach at least minimum 15 minutes before that interview time, you have to reach in that particular location. See whether it is nearer to that particular location, that means whether that bus facility and or other facilities available for that particular place is not, you have to confirm that thing. And for that, you have to that means get idea about the all the things related to that thing. So while preparing for the interviews, we have to consider some sort of the key points which will help you to become a comfortable, and confidently you can attend that particular interview. So these key points are, first one is the introspect is the first key point. Now in this introspect, what you have to consider? You have to consider your strength and weaknesses, which will add, you can see that which will help you whether you can prove yourself for that particular post for that organization. That thing you have to consider one. And another thing is that what you are able to achieve so far, that you keep in mind. That means what is exactly, by considering this, whether you are achieving, it is your achievement or what, that thing you have to keep in mind. All right, that is the first one. Second one is that analyze your background. Yeah, this is one important point. See, analyze your background. That means you have to prepare questions which may be asked related to your personal and family related questions, as well as some qualification related questions. So you have to prepare that particular questionnaire. See, question like tell about yourself. Whenever such a questions they are asking, what at that time you have to explain your background, family background, and your qualifications. Whatever the qualifications you are having, you have to say in a proper manner. Your growth from, that means your growth in your life, you have to explain in a proper way, right? Your friendly relation, within a short time you have to explain these things, so that it will, you can say that gives the some sort of the impress you for that particular question, right? So be confident while giving such a answers and analyze these kind of a things, right, for this particular point. Now highlight your achievements and accomplishment. See here, the achievements and accomplishments, these are two different things, not the same things. Achievements are considered in your academics, and accomplishment, it is a specific thing which is done for that particular specific work, done for that particular specific job, right? Achievements you can consider, that means any award or whatever you are getting, some sort of the prize, fellowship, you can see that certificates like this. And accomplishment in the sense, you can consider your project leading, or you are handling one of the program, like that, like such a things you have to highlight, so that this will that particular say to that particular interviewer, or you can see that these things will convince that particular interviewer that you are the best fit for this particular job. Like that it is the case if you are presenting these highlight achievements and accomplishment in a proper way, right? This is the another key point. Now know your extracurricular activities, right? See, apart from the your academics, that means whatever the academics activity you are having, academics you are in well in academics, all that thing, no problem. But apart from the extracurricular activities, you are from this academics, you are showing that particular extracurricular activities, then it will shows your overall development. That means involvement in the extracurricular activity, it will shows your overall development. In that, you whatever the you are writing that, or you are saying about your hobbies, maybe any that particular, you can say that anything, say basketball or kabaddi, whatever that thing, you have to know all the things related to that particular hobbies. If only you are writing hobbies and you are not having any, that means idea about that thing, then it will throw out from this particular, or it will, you can say that give the bad impression. So avoid such a things, but give some good things related to your that particular, you can say that hobbies and all that things, so that you can able to answer in a confident level. That is the thing. Now next key point is the analyze your skills. Okay, this analyze, that means whatever the you are having the skills, right, you have to present in a impressive, in use some sort of the impressive objective to describe these particular skills. That means you have to analyze your skills and you have to describe this particular thing in a different manner, so that it will, you can say that, get impress you for that particular employer, because he is also you can say that finding the good skilled candidate, right? And you are fitting in that particular pole, that particular post or you are fit for that particular job, then obviously he will also get that particular thing, whatever he is searching. So for that reason, whatever the you are having skills, knowledge, you have to present in a proper manner, and you have to analyze before presenting it one. And you have to see that whether my whatever I am having the skill, whether it fit for that particular job or not, whether it is suitable for that particular job or not. This thing you have to analyze one. You have to prepare for that thing and present accordingly. Right? This is the important key point. Now, and during this process might be, by considering this particular point of view, might be they will ask you questions because you are showing your skills, knowledge for that in that during that particular process. At that time they will ask some sort of the tricky questions. Why do you think you should hire, we should hire you, like that they will ask the question. What makes you fit for this particular position? Might be for that reason you have to analyze yourself and you have to prove that you have to fit for that particular thing. You have to prove in a confident level, confidently, and give that particular answers in a carefully, right? So keep in mind that particular things. Now next one is the pre-interview preparation. In this particular consideration, you have to do the some sort of the homework properly before facing the any interview. See, in this kind of a thing, what you have to do is that whenever you are attending or you are preparing for that particular, or you are going to attend that particular interview, you have to do the some sort of the homework related to your documents and related to your company, not your that particular about the company. See, documents that your educational details or whatever the documents it is showing, your educational details, certificates, all that thing you have to keep ready. But that particular resume, enough number of resume copies of that particular resume you have to prepare one. All the whatever the certificate you are having, you have to keep in one file, so that during that particular interview you can show all that thing. And another thing is that about the company, you have to go thoroughly through that particular company's website. You have to get the entire knowledge about that particular, entire idea about that particular company, so that during that particular interview he is asking any questions, you have to give proper answer for that particular thing. This is the important one, right? That is the thing. Now next point is that behavior during the interview. See, show your decent behavior during the interview, right? Don't you can say that nervous during that particular interview. Be comfortable, right? That okay, and be confident. Control your nervousness, right? Whenever you are entering in the room, at that time seek for the permission, right? Take permission when entering in that particular room. Greet politely. Sit only when they are asking, right? Carry yourself smartly. Remain cool and calm, right? And give the answer properly. Listen every question carefully, okay? And give the right answer to that particular question, okay? Use positive tone, right? And take a time to think for that particular question. Listen everything carefully. Maintain your eye contact. All these things you have to, you can see that it will give you decent behavior. Okay, it will show you are showing your decent behavior, right? And it will increase the, you can see that confidence level. Be, your attitude should be in a proper manner. Okay, positive attitude you have to show, right? And your body language should be in a positive way. Okay, now next one is the post-interview behavior. See, after completing your interview, just write send a letter to that, thanking letter, you can say that, thanking letter or thanking note to that particular company, and ask them when they will intimate for the result. don't, you can see that, what we can say, that irritate them sending repeated message, right? It will again make bad impression. So whatever may be the result, we have to accept that particular result, right? That may be positive, that may be negative, because that again depends on the interviewer, how they are judging you. So these are the some of the key points which is considered during the interview process, and you have to ready for that particular, you have to prepare for that particular interview before attending the that particular process. Okay, so keep in mind. Okay, now next is the next point is the interview skill tips. Okay, in this interview skill tips, you must appear very positive and confident in the interview process, right? Sometimes you become over loosely and then overreact, which makes you appear supercilious and leading you to rejection. So some technique you, okay, some technique you which will help you to improve your interview skills and present yourself as a competent candidate. And these techniques are your body language in interview, opt for the best position, right posture, respect your own space, control your hands and arm movement, smile, eye contact, emulate the interviewer behavior, relax. These are the some sort of the key points are considered which will improve yourself during the interview process, and you can say that it will, you can say that present you as the competent candidate, right? So your body language should be in a positive way. You have to present your, that means that body language should be presented well. If you are having, you are prepared well one, then automatically your body will be, that means as you are confident one, automatically body will be react on that particular situation, and it will show that you are a, that means whatever you are saying, it is a true and right one, and you are showing the you can say that you are having the good confidence level, you are having good skills, and you are presenting in that particular manner. Okay, if suppose that interview room is big one, at that time you have to consider proper location so that everybody will see you properly, and you can also see all the interview viewers, those who are present in that panel, right? So it will, again you can see that observers and as well as you will be confident whenever you are considering this kind of a thing. Okay, right posture, you have to be right, that means you have to sit in a proper way in that particular interview room. Okay, relax, you have to keep relaxed, and you have to sit properly, keep your arms, if suppose table is there, you have to keep your arms so that your elbow should be some sort of the outside of that particular table, and you are sitting in a proper manner, your feet are on the ground. Like that you have to sit, be comfortably, and it will increase your confidence level. Control your hands and arms movements, which is considered for that particular human as a natural thing, but don't be over for this particular movement. Okay, so that observer or that interviewer will react on your that particular thing. So keep that much, only sufficient movement or only necessary movement you have to keep, and do that particular things only whenever it is required. Smile. Okay, whenever you are entering in that particular interview room, you have to keep smile one, not that much loud one, only small, that means that whatever it is visible one, just keep smile one. Okay, unnecessary smile which will says that you are not comfortable one. Okay, if you are giving good smile, then at that time if they are saying that okay, both will be, you can say that in that particular position so that they can communicate with each other properly. You can see that communication, conversation, you can say also conversation, they can make the conversation properly, right? These things you have to remember one. Keep your eye contact properly, that means you don't stare on interviewer, only you have to keep the eye contact. If suppose panels are there, that means two or more than two people are considering that panel, so we have to keep the eye contact everybody with everybody, because at which moment that particular interviewer, which interviewer will ask that question, you don't know. But whenever they are asking, at that time you have to keep your eye contact with that particular interviewer and you have to give the answer in a proper way. If you are staring your eyes or you are not keeping your eye contact, that means it says that you are not confident with your that particular thing, and you are your bad impression will be considered for that particular process. So, and be relaxed. Don't, that means, take that much stress, right, during this particular process. Keep relax yourself. Keep in mind that whatever will be happen, it will be a good one, right? Like that, create a positiveness in your mind. If you are prepared well one, then automatically your whatever the that particular interview will be, it will be considered in a positive way. So keep relax your mind and confident, so that interview process will be complete in a proper way. So these are the some of the tips which will help you to improve or that particular confident during that particular interview process, and you can present yourself as a competent candidate for that particular post. Okay, that thing is considered. Students, if you are having any doubts related to it, you can ask me anytime. Okay, thank you.